but you know I can't leave without you. So here's my heart.
Hey, Belinda.
Here's my mind. I give you my soul, Lord. Need you to take control. Cause I tried it all. Tried it on my own.
Hey, Dr. Manny. Hey, Kiki. Hey, Cheryl. Hey, Cheryl, my towel is still covered. Hey, Bishop Brooks. Hey, Treva.
I can't even breathe without you.
What can I do without the Lord? Where would I be without Him? I mean, I couldn't move, couldn't do nothing if I didn't have the Lord. That was our boy Ty Tribbett. Well, my boy, I don't know. Put him on you. You might even like Ty Tribbett. But anyway, I like the song, okay? Ty Tribbett, what can I do? That's a song, that's a thought. What can I do without the Lord? But the Bible tells us, without me, ye can't do nothing. I am so glad for another Tuesday night. That brings us to Sunday School Live. We are here once again. Talking about Samson, that boy right there, that dude, he was too much for his own good. He was a womanizer. Yeah, I said it. He was a woman. He had issues. But he finally got it right. But it was, anyway, we're going to talk about it. Now, if you did, put it in the comments. Say, I read the entire chapter. Because I asked y'all last week to read the entire chapter. Because we're going to do the entire chapter. It ain't going to take me long. You know, I'm gonna talk about Samson. Talking about that little flighty girl called Delilah. And, you know, we're gonna run through it. Not run through it, but, you know, it's going to be, I'm going to give you enough to go with. You know, so that's what we're going to be talking about tonight. Like I say, men, be careful whose lap you lay your head in. And ladies, be careful, because you could have a good thing, and the enemy will cause you to mess that thing up. See that? Hey, Minister Downs, how you doing? I'm good right there. Anyway, so we're going to be talking about Samson. So let's start this thing by praying. Father God, we thank you for your grace and mercy, your love and kindness. We thank you for just being God. Lord, we praise you because you've allowed us to see another day. You allowed us to almost see another month. And Lord, we thank you for bringing us thus far. We never knew how this year was going to be. We never knew how it was going to begin. And we don't know how it's going to end. But Lord, we thank you for your covering, for your blessings, for your love, for your blood, for your will. Lord, keep us in your will and in your way. Keep our minds and our hearts stayed on you. Keep us focused on you. All the distractions that come to take our minds and our hearts off of you, Lord, get them out of the way. And let us see you. Let us see your beauty in everything and in everyone. Lord, don't let us be deceived by the enemy. Don't let us be distracted by the enemy, Lord. But touch us right now in the name of Jesus. Keep us in your will and in your way, Lord Jesus. Cover us. Lord, you know what we need. You know what we desire. You know what we have need of. You know where we need to be, where we should be, where we are going to be. Lord, keep us on the right path and on the right track. Lord, as we go through this lesson on tonight, open up our hearts, minds, and understanding that we may receive your word and not be like the people in this story on tonight. Lord, help us to be better people, better men, better women, better boys, better girls, better humans, better preachers, better saints, better witnesses, better ministers. Lord, you know where our lives are going. You know what's going on. You writing our story. We are letting you pen what happens in our life. Lord, we thank you for this night. We thank you for the Sunday school lesson. Lord, as I teach this lesson, let it be all of you and none of me. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. My Lord, my strength, and my redeemer. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. All right. Lust and grace. What you say, girl? I hear you. Hey, Linzola, my love. How are you? Good to see you. Good to see you. All right. We are talking about final victory. Oh, boy. He did a bunch of stuff. Yes, he did. But this victory, his final victory, will mean more than anything he's ever done. Amen. Amen. So, the lesson for tonight is coming from Judges, the 16th chapter, 21 through 31. But me being a person of a whole story, I don't like taking pieces of a story, throwing it at you. You know, like the Sunday school people, they take a piece of story, throw it at you and say, figure it out. That's why I asked y'all to read the whole chapter. Because we're going to deal with the whole chapter. You said, oh my God, it's 31 verses. Y'all know how I teach a lesson. I'm not fixing to take no rabbit trails, no back roads, no scouts, no rabbit hunting, no dog tracking, none of that. I just go through the lesson, say what needs to be said, and move on. Y'all know how I do that. But anyway, we're going to talk about this boy's name, Samson. Now, we know he fought some people last week, and he took out 1,000 Philistines with the jawbone of an ass, and then God took the same jawbone and gave him some water. So we know that God is looking over his silliness. And like I said, you know, Samson, being the pretty boy that he was, knew he was a pretty boy and used that to his advantage. That's why when we're pretty, we got to be careful. We got to keep ourselves covered with God. Say, God, God, you made me good. Yes, you did. You put all my stuff away. Anyway, and, you know, we got to be close to God because folks will blow our minds. Tell us how good we look, how we all in the back chest. We finer than, you know, we're thicker than a snicker and all this kind of stuff. And then we forget God because we done been told so. And then, you know, oh man, you're so fine. You are just, oh my God, you, ooh wee, man, you are just, oh my God, you're so fine. Yeah, baby, I know, you know, so, yeah, okay, stop. If you know who you are in God, you know, don't let your mind get blown, because Satan will blow your mind. But we're finna talk about, you know, Samson and how he got tripped up by two hoes. Now, I mean, excuse me, two women, I mean, they hoes, anyway, two hoes. Men, be careful of the hoes. They come to church now. Uh-oh, I said, sweet, I got to do better on my, no, I don't. Okay, but anyway, let's go. Let's be 16th chapter. We're starting at the first, but come on, let's roll. And when Samson took Gaza, now this is after he done killed the 1,000 Philistines. Okay, it's the 16th chapter of, hey, Penedra, 16th chapter of Judges. Then went Samson to Gaza and saw there an harlot and went in unto her. See, here you go. A harlot. A prostitute. A hoe. I mean, what you going into? He just can't do right. He just got to go. He got to. He got to. I mean, what in the world? I'm sorry. Well, come on, dog. You know me. Come on, man. And so, you know, I mean, he just, here you go. What you doing? Dude, okay, now here we go. So they still trying to figure out, Samson is a problem. Samson is a problem. We need to get rid of this dude. He is causing too much havoc. So they said, and it was told to the Gazites, saying, Samson has come hither, and they compassed him in and laid wait for him all night in the gate of the city and were quiet all the night, saying, in the morning, when it is day, we shall kill him. Now look. I know they were somewhere near the last chapter. I don't know if they was in the next town, I don't know. But I know they had heard about this man named Samson. This dude can snatch folks with no problem. He just kicked, well, I'm sorry, let's back up. Remember when the dudes was, you know, when they saw, when he, you know, the 300, I mean, let's, no, the 30 change of clothes, let's start there. He went and killed 30 folks to get the change of clothes. He didn't go in his clothes. He went and stole somebody else's clothes. Had to kill him. And then he killed 300 foxes to send them through the corns and stuff. And then he killed 1,000 men. And then, okay. And then when they tied him up, he then woke up. I mean, like he wasn't even tied. They tied him with new rope. New rope's supposed to be strong. Okay, anyway, let's go. With they waiting all night. See, it says, so Samson lay wait till midnight and rose at midnight and took the doors of the gate of the city and the two posts and went away with them, bar and all, and put them up on his shoulders and carried them up to the top of an hill that is before Hebron. Okay, now listen. Look, what did they say? They lay wait for him all night in the gate of the city. They were right there at the gate of the city. They were waiting on Samson. Samson woke up at midnight, looked at them, took the post, the doorpost, the gate. And now, you know, if it's made like it's supposed to be, it's in the ground. It's not, you can't just pull it up like talking. But this dude pulled it up like talking about it and took it on with him and carried it up on his shoulder and carried it to the top of the hill and dropped it. And so when they wake up with the whole things, they're going to be like, what that dude at? He going to get his next meal. Okay, it said, and it came to pass afterward that he loved a woman. Here you go again. In the valley of Sorek, whose name was Delilah. Delilah. She was pretty. He was in love. It wasn't love, y'all. Come on now. It was lust. He was in lust. I mean, he just, you know? But he still had in the back of his mind that he is a Nazarite. He ain't supposed to cut his hair. He ain't supposed to have strong drink. He ain't supposed to eat certain food. But he was trying to, you know, okay. And then here go this woman that you love so much. But I wonder, did she love him? We ain't gonna talk about that. Because we already know. You be careful who you love. Because just because you love them, they might just lust you. Uh-oh. Yeah, I said it. Yeah. So that's how we get messed up and hurt. Because we love somebody. I'm sorry. Anyway, so we got to be careful about who we love and make sure they love us too. Because if they're just lusting, then they're going to lust for somebody and something and some people else. You know, like I said, you know. You got a married? No. Okay. You got a girl? No. You got how many baby mamas you got? You got a boyfriend? Wait a minute. Boyfriend? That's what I said. Oh, you caught that, didn't you, Cheryl? Caught it. She said emphasis on lie. And I just, that's why I said the lie, look. Because you get wrapped up in something in some situations and with some people, you end up lying. Because you ain't where you supposed to be and they ain't who you ain't supposed to be with them no way. God and already told God send me somebody and God then somebody come and you think that's what Lord sent because they bought you a flower and a Big Mac combo meal. Large. What did it say? Super size? They don't say that no more. Medium and large. Hey Lenore. Lenore no slid in on me. Huh? Okay, don't be giving up stuff. Hey Pastor, oh my pastor on here, y'all. Let me act right. No, he know I'm crazy. I ain't finna. And so, you know, don't get caught up behind a happy meal and a smile. Ooh, that just came to me. Okay, so y'all don't get wrapped. Okay, let's see what Delilah doing. Delilah. 4 for 4. Lynn, stop it. Oh, my God. I'm not going to play with you and share tonight. I'm not. Oh, the Philistines came upon her and said unto her, entice him. And see where in his great strength lies. See, they didn't hear about his strength, so we need to knock him down a couple of pegs. That we may prevail against him, that we may bind him to afflict him, and we will give thee, every one of us, 1,100 pieces of silver. Baby, don't you tell me, 1,100 pieces of silver. And they say that's about $715 back then. Baby, you entice him, rub on him a couple times, blow in his ear, baby, and let him make it take so we can get him and take over. Okay. But you see, if she had loved him like he loved her, she would have got them out of their face. And see, women, when you have a significant, Belinda, when you have a significant other and you say you love them, you can't be letting folks interfere and intertwine in your situation. Because some folks will have you messing up yours so they can get what you got. Verse 6. And Delilah said to Samson, and you know how she was talking, she wasn't talking like I'm talking now. Tell me, I pray thee, where in thy great strength lies, and where with thy might be bound to afflict thee? What is your weakness, sweetie? Oh, sweetheart. Oh, sorry. And Delilah said to Samson, and Samson said unto her, if you bind me with 7 green withs that will never dry, then shall I be weak and like another man. Tie me with some new cords, new strength. Come on now. Huh? Cheryl, 100% all be patted. I'm not playing with y'all today. I told y'all, leave me alone. I'm finna go on with this. So, he said, then the lords of the Philistines brought up to her 7 green withs which had not been dried, and she bound him with them. She tied him up. See that? She's gonna tie up her man so she wouldn't have killed him, get her man beat down for $715. She wanted that new dress, didn't it? She wanted to. That might have been a down payment. No, that might have been a car. Wait, I'm sorry. A tricked out chariot. There you go. That's what she wanted. A tricked out chariot for $715. She might have had some change over. But anyway. Then the lords of the Philistine brought unto her the 7 green she bound them. Now there were men lying in wait, abiding with her in the train. She done let some old men in to get her man. How that sound? You gonna tie up your man for some other men to get your man? But he loved it, huh? Okay. So they was in the chamber, and he said unto him, the Philistines be upon thee, Samson. And he break the wits as a thread of tow is broken when it touched the fire. Eh? So his strength was not known. Godly. That ain't it. He broke. What? You ready to whoop somebody? And then Delilah said unto Samson, behold, you have mocked me. I feel so terrible. And told me lies. You ought to know a lie when you see one. You a lie too, so you got anyway. Now tell me, I pray thee, wherewith thou mightest be bound. Now a man in his right mind would have stopped and said, what you want to know for? What you trying to do? How you trying to, set me up or something? But no, he ain't thinking. Here. I'm going to let y'all figure that out. It's, okay. And he said unto her, if thou bind me fast with new ropes that never were occupied and never used, then I shall be weak and be as another man. And here she go again. Delilah. Took the new ropes and bound him therewith and said unto him, the Philistine be upon thee, Samson. And there were lies in wait abiding in a chamber again. She got them dudes back up in now. And he break them off his arms like a thread. Now, if the Philistines was smart, but they was dumb for a reason. God had them dumb for a reason. God had Samson like he is for a reason. And let God let all this happen. God will, if you don't do what you need to do, God will allow you to fall into a trap that you can't get yourself out of. Okay, here we go. And Delilah said unto Samson, hitherto thou hast mocked me and told me lies. Tell me wherewith thou mightest be bound. And he said unto her, if thou weavest, he laying in a lap now. He relaxed. You know, you lay your head in the wrong lap, Because usually people that, when they trying to trap you, women trying to trap you, they make sure everything smell good. So you laying in her lap, and all your senses done kicked in, so you trying. And you thinking. And instead of saying, whoo, let me get up here and go, he was in love, so all that. So she said, you done mocked me. And you told me lies. All right, baby, okay, see. If you cut my hair off my head with the weave, and she fastened a pin and said, you cut the weave is the 7 locks of my head with the web. Just, and she fastened and said, ooh, here we go. We're gonna put, still trying to figure it out. She fastened with a pin. Now, if the stuff, if you can't be bound with ropes, how you think if you fasten my hair is going to be? Anyway, see that Philistine bib on, here she go again. Wait, I see him went away with the pin or the beam and the weave. Everything just grabbed. Now, let me help you out. Back in the day, and maybe a weave, you know how we had them little things that we used to use on the little square thing? And how some people can weave. But back in the day, it was a big old situation, almost as big as a harp. And that's what the weaving loom was. And that's what he drug. He drug everything and then that. So okay, she said it to him. How can I say, baby, you tell me you love me, but your heart is not with me. How can you love me and lie to me? Thou hast mocked me these 3 times and hast not told me where that grace strength lies. Baby, you don't love me. You must tell me. I need to know. You say you love me. And it came to pass when she pressed him daily with her words and urged him. She talked with her words and she urged him. She knew what touch to get him to soften. She knew what stroke to use. She knew what would get him calm. And talking, don't be playing like you don't know. You done use some moves to get what you want, ladies, men. You done use some moves to get what you want. Most times you get it. And then you find yourself in a situation, okay? And it said his soul was vexed unto death. She got on his last nerve. Now, if a woman keeps trying, she love me, she keeps trying to find out what my strength is, and you know that's the key to your life, why would you look him? But he loved that girl past senses. You ever love somebody till you lost your sense? But anyway, that's I'm not gonna wait for the answer. We're gonna go on. Then he told her all his heart. See what wrong? See, touching, feeling, soothing, kissing, whispering. Ooh, hey Linda. All that. And so he told her all his heart. Let the devil keep playing with you, baby, and you'll tell him everything. Because he disguises himself to be your boo thing. He disguises himself to be your sweetheart. He disguises himself to be somebody that will give you the world. And they can't even scoop up a spoonful of dirt. Okay, all right. Moving on. And said unto her, there hath not come a razor upon mine head, for I have been a Nazarite unto God from my mother's womb. If I be shaven, then my strength will go from me, and I shall become weak and be like any other man. Yes, she nagged him to death, literally. So when Delilah saw that he had told her all his heart, the devil know when you done pulled it out. Man know when he got you. Woman know what she got, and she get what she want. He get what he want, and he gone. He leave you a couple of dollars, and she leave you. Maybe she might leave you. Anyway, they leave something. and then you stuck. Sometimes for the rest of your life, you stuck with it. You better count off the cost, yeah. Okay, and said, then she told my father, sent a call for the Lord's Philistine, saying, come up this once, for he has showed me all his heart. Woo! Hey, Apostle Harris, how you doing? All his heart. Then the Lord's of the Philistines came up unto her and brought her money, $715. She done betrayed the man that loved her for $715. Some of y'all done betrayed folks for less than that. Okay. And she made him sleep upon her knees. She rubbed his head. I'm sorry, played in his hair. Rubbed on his chest. If he was on his stomach, then she rubbed his back. And she made sure he was asleep, he was resting, he was comfortable. Wasn't nothing gonna happen to him because he was laying in her lap. And I done told y'all, when a man is laid in a woman's lap and a woman ain't right, she makes sure everything smell good, so he just get hypnotized by the aromas and the scents of strawberry, the peaches, the cream, the all that. And all you, you don't smell that stench yet, but it's smelling good right now. That fragrance gonna leave in a minute. Mm-hmm. That's how we get trapped by fragrances and scents and stuff. And she said, but I'm not claiming to. She said, Philistines be upon this sense. And he woke out of sleep and said, I will go out as at other time before and shake myself. And he wist not that the Lord was departed from him. He didn't know the Lord had departed. See, that's just how it is. You be in God and you say you're saved, sanctified, Holy Ghost filled, fire baptized. You better stay right there. You better stay close. Because you get hooked up with the wrong Negro, the wrong female, the wrong dictionary for this nina. And then you end up trapped in a situation that you can't get out of. And I say, I got this. And then you end up in a situation you don't know. You end up at the doctor and don't know how you coped. You end up at the doctor and say, I'm what? You end up at the doctor and say, I got who? What? You end up with the doctor and you say, I'm a Hannah. Is it curable? I don't know. We're going to try this. Can I fix it? I don't know. We're going to try this. Then you rock between the rock and the hard place because you stopped and you kept going and he didn't even know his hair had been cut because he was laying in the wrong lap. He was so relaxed and so rested he didn't even know his hair was being tugged to cut. He didn't feel the tug of his hair, and he didn't hear the razor or the scissors or the knife or whatever they used to cut hair. He didn't hear none of that, didn't feel none of that, but he got up. He knew he was feeling different when he woke up because he didn't feel that automatic strength come. You ever notice when you get into stuff and you stop dealing with God and you stop, you don't pray no like you used to, you don't sing like it used to, you don't read your word like it used to, and then all of a sudden stuff started getting in your way or start bothering you. You start getting mad and you don't even know why. God's sitting over there in the corner waiting on you to come back. You don't even know. And you trying to talk to somebody, you trying to tell about the Lord, and you talking all crazy. Why? Because the Lord done left you. But you don't realize he gone because you've been in the middle of so much stuff. Get out that stuff. Come out from among them. Quit looking. Women, God ain't told us to look. He said he that finds a wife, find a good thing. But like I said, stop trying to be a good thing and try to work on being a wife. And what I mean by that, we done spend too long being good things. But you need to work on being a wife if that's what you wish to be. And no, you're not a wife if y'all just in the same house. Okay, let me move on. I'm going to make some folks mad at me, but do I care? Nope. But the Philistines took him and put out his eyes and brought him down to Gaza and bound him with fetters of brass, and he did grind in the prison house. He was still, he had no power. And then they blinded him because he couldn't do nothing. Now he can't see. He ain't got no power. Oh, my God. Blind with no power. How you gonna see something if you blind? How you gonna act upon anything if you can't see? You can't get no power. Ooh, blind and weak. Cause you told a hoe your heart. Then, how be it? You cut it. It's, oh Lord, I'm sorry. Look, Lynn, get back up, baby. You all right? Okay. I hope you all right. Okay. So, it had been the hair of his head began to grow again after it was shaved. But you done messed up now because, you know, we try to fix stuff. Okay, Lord. Okay, Lord. I know I messed up. but I won't do it again. I won't do it too, but yeah. Okay. I won't do it. So my hair don't grow back now. So I feel like, okay, God has forgiven me. No, you done disobeyed. He told you, don't cut your hair. That was the obedience part. But your hair got cut. So yes, your hair got cut. But you see, he's still weak and he's still blind. Even though his hair grew back. Don't think you just because you try to fix it and make it pretty. God told you not to. Huh? God told you not to. Corey on his. Oh, hey, Corey, I tell myself, how he get by me? Okay. It told you what not to do. And you do it anyway. And then you say, oh, well, look, I'm going to go. Okay. Okay, Lord, see. Okay, I'm going to church. I'm going to church. Okay, so I'm going to go Bible study. I'm gonna go to the revival. Okay, so no, you need to get it right with God. But see, God had already set you up, and He said, "Thou shalt not." Huh? Okay, I'm sorry. Let me go and finish this hymn right here. His hair grew back. Then the lords of the Philistines gathered themselves together to offer a great sacrifice unto Dagon, their god, and to rejoice, for they said, "Our God." Well, Dagon, that's a bad dude. Stature, but they think he a dude. Our God said, deliver Samson, our enemy, into our hands. You in for a rude awakening, bro. You caught the wrong dude. And when the people saw him, they praised their God, for they said, our God had delivered into our hands our enemy, and the destroyer of our country, which slew many of us, we got him. Woo! God, we got out. Ooh, he done wrecked heaven. He done messed up. He done dust up. He done. Oh my God, dude, we got. Oh my God. Ooh, Dagon. This man. Ooh, our God, Dagon. Delivered this man into our hands. Man. Y'all remember when the enemy thought they had you? When the enemy thought you were down for the cat? He said, "Up, one, two, hey, three, four, count five, six, what you say, seven? Wait a minute, he getting up, I'm getting up, and I'm up, what? He thought he was going to get to 10, but he didn't make it. Okay. He said it was happy, and it came to pass when their hearts were made, hey, and they say, call for Samson that he may make us sport. And they called for Samson out of prison, and he made them sport. And they set him between the pillars. Uh-oh. Full mention. Oh, we got it. Woo-hoo. We ain't gonna have to worry about you no more. Pass me some more wine. What the heck? Come here. Woo! Give another turkey leg. What the? Man, you just. Woo! Woo! Just do. What the heck? Okay. Put him between the pillows. And Samson said unto the lad, the little boy that held him by the hand, suffer me that I may feel the pillows well upon the house standing, that I may lean upon them. Uh-oh. He said, now I need to feel them. Pillow right here. I just need to rest. Need to relax a little bit. And I'm going to lean up. Now the house was full of men and women, and all the lords of the Philistines were there. And there were up on the roof about 3,000 men and women that beheld while Samson made sport. He just stood there, ha! They up there, ha! Made. Samson, you dead, bro. We going to get you. We get. No. No. No, that ain't how this story go in. And Samson called unto the Lord. Oh, now you won't call the Lord. After all you done did, now you won't call the Lord. But like Cheryl said earlier, lust then grace. Your lust ain't got you in the situation you in now. But grace is going to allow you your final victory. And Samson took her. Oh, I'm sorry. Let me back up. Oh, Lord God, remember me, I pray thee, and strengthen me, I pray thee, only this once. Oh, God, that I may be at once avenged of the Philistines for my two eyes. Lord, I'm not asking you for my sight. I'm not asking you for full strength. I'm just asking you for this one time. If you give me strength, that I may be avenged of my adversaries. I don't want my sight, my God. You don't owe me no more favors, God. Hey, God, Jesus. You don't owe me no more favors. Because you've done enough. I was too ignorant to understand and grasp what you were doing in my life, or what you could have done in my life. But at this moment, I need you to give me strength. And Samson took hold of the two middle pillars upon which the house stood, and it was borne up of the one hand and the other with his left. These are the two pillars that support the entire building. And understand, it said 3,000 men and women were up on the wall. And he asked for two to strength. One pillar on the right side, one pillar on the left. And Samson said, let me die with the Philistines. And he bowed himself with all his might, and the house fell upon the lords and upon the people that were therein. So the dead which he slew at his death were more than they which he slew in his life. That one moment of grace allowed him to be avenged of his adversary and God's enemy. That's why you got to be careful when you try to avenge yourself because of what other folks did to you. The Bible says, vengeance is mine. I will repay, said the Lord. He will take care of. He will make your enemies your footstool. Not you. God will. He said, then his brother and all the house of his father came down and took him and brought him up and burned him between Zorah and Ashtol, in the burying place of Manoah his father. And he judged Israel for 20 years. I don't know where he was judging that. They didn't talk about his judging. I don't know. Maybe he's a good old dude. But anyway, he just messed up. You got to be careful where your desires are. I just can't be alone. I got to have a man.
I got to have a woman by my side.
I just can't be. You better learn how to. Because you're going to end up with a whole bunch of stuff, people, things, issues, diseases, bugs, roaches, worms, all that. You know, you just don't want all that. We don't want to be coming visit you because you're in quarantine and not for COVID-19. Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Here we go with the practical points. Some of y'all might need to reread that so you don't get trapped. Mm-hmm. All right. Practical points. There are often outward consequences to sin, even when God forgives you. You see that? Outward consequences to sin. God forgave me, but he didn't give him his sight back. His hair grew back because that's what hair does. It grows back. He didn't give him his strength back neither. But he asked God one more time to give me the strength to do this just one more time. He said, I don't even deserve to live. Because I've messed over your grace. Some of us know we done messed over God's grace. Some people still messing over God's grace. Stop it. Embrace his grace. Enjoy his grace. Because his grace is freeing. His grace is sweet. His grace is tasty. His grace will cover you when nobody else can. God shows us grace even though we do not deserve it. No, we don't. No, we don't. But God shows us grace every day. His mercies are renewed every day. Do you see what kind of love that is? You could have 20 points of grace and mess up 12, and that leaves you with 8. And God lets you roll over to the next day. Now what you going to do with the 8 you got left? No. He restores you. Hey, Sharon. He restores your whole, and just give you some more. He adds some more every day. New mercy, brand new. He forget what you did yesterday, and he said, okay, I'm gonna cover you today. Brand new mercies. He forgets. When we say, forgive me, Lord, and we mean it with a sincere heart, he forgets. Why us folk that say we saved, I want to be like Jesus. Want to be like Jesus. All I want to be lame. Quit lying. If you ain't trying, quit lying. Because some of the stuff folks do, y'all do, we do, we ain't in it. We know doggone well it ain't got nothing to do with Jesus. Okay, next one. Listen to this. The ungodly often interpret the setbacks of God's people as proof that God does not exist or does not care for his people. See, people get caught up that they think that saints don't have issues. We do. We just handle them. We're supposed to handle them different. If you're going through problems, you're going through pressure and strain, I should be able to walk up to you and say, yeah, right? If you say, if you're a baby in Christ, and I expect, you need a little help. But if you in there, been in there, you're supposed to be a soldier on the battlefield fighting for the Lord, and you got your sword, she in the old armor, okay? I should be able to tell if something wrong. I mean, deeper than something wrong. You know, sometimes you can't hide what's going on, okay? You try, and you be looking. But if you're a sweet, sweet child of God, then I could walk up to you. Walk up to you and say, my love, what's going on? My smile, your smile, I'm used to you smiling. You ain't smiling. I'm used to you not doing it. No, I'm not going to get the mic. I see you, sister. It's something wrong with you. You're looking crazy today. So Satan has already now brought snitch. No. Put him to the side. Talk to him one-on-one. Let folks trust you. Lord have mercy. Let folks trust you. We got enough of non-trust. Folks don't trust church folks like they used to, because church folks just as messy as the road dogs. Oh, did I say it? Yeah, I said it. So be a trustworthy person. If somebody tell you something and it's just you and they shouldn't even hear it again. Okay, next. The unrighteous believe that the Lord is powerless, not to be taken seriously. Okay, then. Do you believe that if you want to? The Lord is powerless, and he created the world. The earth is the Lord, and the fullness of it up. They that dwell in it. What? Is you crazy? Okay. Keep believing that, baby. And if I got the Lord in me, baby, I'm not powerless either. You know how they take your meekness for weakness? I don't know if nobody takes my... Never mind. Okay, anyway, so because I'm just... Anyway, okay. It's better to suffer. Okay. It's better to suffer in righteousness than to perish in unrighteousness. You hear that? It's better to go through and let the Lord take you through and let him strengthen you than to die and you silly. Yeah, because you didn't want to do what God told you to do. That's too hard. I can't do it. I don't know what to do. Alright. Y'all gonna be like when you come. Hey, Lord. I know you. What you? Yeah, Lord, I'm the one that was sitting on the third row, right side up on the corner. And, you know, I used to. Yeah, I saw you. But my heart, your heart wasn't with me, so I cast them out. I'll let you take them on. I ain't finna go through hell and then go to hell. No, it ain't happening. Though we make mistakes, God is always ready to turn them around for his purposes. Now, let me explain a mistake. You know, when you first start out, you're going to make some mistakes because you don't know everything. You don't know everything. You know, there's people that's going to help you with this journey. Then you know, is it? But then after a while, you know the way. You know what to do and what not to do. That's not a mistake. And if you do it more than once, it's not a mistake. It's a problem that you need to go to God. Say, God, I need you to take this from me. Whatever it is. If it's not of God, God needs to remove it. Well, I'm trying to wean my... No, baby. Sweetie, honey pie, child, chocolate pudding pop. No, sweetie, love you, honey bun, cherry, sauce, strawberry, mint, and no. God needs to remove it, because if you're trying to wean yourself, you're going to get drowned by weaning. Samson's final victory. Don't let your life end up in a fatality, in your finality, because you wouldn't do what God told you to do. And then God be like, you know, on that, like on the Mortal Kombat, finish him. You don't want that to happen. So, keep your focus on God. When there's a calling on your life, you got to be even more focused. You got to stay on your knees. You got to stay in God's face. You got to stay in his presence. You got to consult him at all times. God should be your consultant. Yeah, you can go to your pastor. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can go to a strong person in the church. Mm-hmm. But God is your ultimate consultant. So let's be doers of the word. James 1, 22. Be ye doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. You ain't fooling nobody when you messing up. Huh? You think you fooling folk. But we see them hairs sticking out. No, you be trying to wear sheep clothing. She growing extra hair. Nobody knows her. That's all. So stay focused. Stay right there. Stay right there. Don't you move that I take. Stay there until his will is clear. Stay there until he bless you. And if you walk away with a limp, come on, Jacob. It's going to be all right. Because every time you... Whew, okay, I remember. that was when I was with the Lord. But stay in the race. Race is not given to the swift. Neither the battle to the strong. But it's the one that endured to the end that shall be saved. Huh? Alright. Well, that brings us to the end of another lesson. See the God, Lisa, I told you we did a whole chapter in less than an hour. I told y'all, don't take me long. I don't understand why I've been taking so, but anyway, it's just me. I told God what I wanted, and he did just okay. So next week we're gonna talk about Samuel's leadership brings victory. Okay? Now, if you want the lessons, I did put them on this page. So go back down, I think, maybe two or three posts, and you'll see the lessons, because they don't put them on the website like they used to because of COVID-19, people not ordering or whatever, okay? But the book is available at Flynn's Church Supply on Earn Avenue, sorry. And this is a book, it's $7. And, you know, if you want a book, you just come here. And like I said, I got a list on this page where you can keep up, okay? All right, so... 1 Samuel, we're going to start out in 1 Samuel 7 chapter 1 through 12. It says, Samuel's leadership brings victory. I love y'all. Ain't nothing you can do about it. I enjoy y'all feedback. I enjoy y'all loving on me. I just enjoy it all. Man, I'm scared. And the reason why I'm scared is because we have Bible study tomorrow night. And I'm like... Me and Dr. Ryan have been on point. You know, we've been in sync for the last few weeks, and I'm scared. I don't know what he gonna do this time, man. But anyway, I love y'all. Y'all keep praying for me. I'm gonna be normal. Okay, never mind. I'm gonna stay just like I'm is. Okay? All right. Good night. Mwah.